as everybody on the side of Longju really wants to terrorize this top side. Okay, we have the long-range engage here from Lindorong.
That's right, this might get a little dicey.
He's going to stun here onto Cuz, but he still has Repel. This is a 4-on-3, actually, as Key makes his way up. Now it's just up to Longju to try to get out of this one, but Khan cannot. It's going to be first blood.
Going to the bottom lane, but nothing to be found.
See that Prey just steps forward a little bit too much. That's
Longju going to take this opportunity to summon the Rift Herald, knowing that the bottom lane had recalled. And even BDD.
But they will free them up to look for engages as a team elsewhere on the map. Meanwhile, Rox is going for this Mountain Drake. The Cocoon is going to land in a totally max range there. And a huge seismic shove! What a play by BDD! But as I say that, this is turning around. Cuz is going to go down as well as Gorilla. These guys are not as tanky as they believe. But Rox, have they pushed too far forward? Prey still on the chase.
He's going to flash.
He's going to tag down Lindorong here, dodging that stun too. Connie's looking for the pillar. He's extremely fast. Can they actually knock him off? Prey trying to sacrifice his life.
Great.
There's
pillar.
The Perilla! And the Featherstorm comes out. Can he drag it into someone? He does, into Khan!
One
but
more.
The last auto gets him on his way out. What a play there. Let's take another look here at this incredible seismic shove, because that's really what gets this started. The flash seismic sub to get four of them is a beauty.
Great follow-up by Gorilla as well. Although he does die, it does buy enough time for everybody to close in and let Prey basically do the cleanup duty.
Gorilla just got a little bit excited. He's like, oh, we're going to win this fight big time. And he realized that he's a very underleveled Morgana compared to the rest of the team. So does go down immediately. And at the same time, Cuz is pretty weak as well, and he gets taken out. But nice chasing there by the side of Longju, I think.
As we do get a replay of what exactly threatened Prey.
Wow. Spikes like an arrow. Unlucky. His RNG was quite bad there.
Tended
for sure.
To flash over the arrow instead of simply being unlucky.
It was pretty close. Cuz, oh, he got out of position here. Perfect for Key to jump on top of him.
And on recalling as well.
Okay, they're looking for a TP here. Here we go. Oh boy, everybody on the side of Rox is dodging every CC that Longju has. Look at that. Prey eating a ton of damage out there from Lava. Now Khan in a weird spot is going to have to back. Wait, there's the ultimate. Prey just walking into the Syndra and eating it. And he's going to go down, obviously.
Stopping it before it even happened. There it is. Let's take a look at this fight.
It was really Sangyun that forced everything. What a good dodge once again. And they walk into the Syndra and the feathers, and Prey just gets so chunked. And we're going to see the flash here. Yeah, Prey just not expecting it.
There it is, right there. You could see the Longju players somewhat turn around right before Prey gets flashed on. I think they understood, hey, Prey is low, let's not do this. But
they know this. Rox is preparing for all of this kind of long-range CC, and it's very hard for Longju to really link up more than one, especially with the happy beat going on. So we got a wall coming down here. Look at how much damage Khan has taken. And in the front line as well, is going to almost go down. The ultimate coming down onto Khan. Cuz still trying to get damage. Sangyun extremely low as well. Nobody can get on top of him. Finally, he goes down. Prey in the back line, totally protected. Looks like he should have enough. Khan now on the chase for Key. He's going to take him out. And Prey still alive with full health, with red buff. And Key going to get chomped. To make matters worse.
And the Baron goes over to Longju, and nobody actually thought about Prey. All right, let's, the moment of truth.
Watch Prey in this fight, because as you said, he's really the big damage dealer for them. He comes from the top side. They just don't see him. He dodges all of Maokai's stuff. And then once he gets in position, there's no one to deal with him.
He's hitting Xayah, he's hitting Rakan, he's hitting Maokai, Gragas. He's literally inside three people, and none of the Rock Tigers actually have the idea to actually turn and get rid of the Ash.
Yeah.
Inhibitor turret and the wave that they have prepared.
Oh, boy.
Fix.
That was pretty close. Meanwhile, Khan, he's being thrown around the arena. He's still okay somehow. Still hasn't gone down. They don't have enough damage to follow up. And, oh, boy, Lava, he gets locked down for so long, hit by that binding. And you could say goodbye if you get hit by one of those long CCs. Another one goes down. Longju does like to do that as well. They do have that kind of same characteristic in terms of macro play. And this is kind of funny. Let's watch Khan get thrown around and still not die. Not enough damage.
Not sure what it was that gave him that little burst of health at the end. He doesn't have a gargoyle awareness that Prey just displayed. Although Nature's Grasp coming in from behind. Literally with teleport play, but Xayah deleted.
Totally deleted, and with Black Shields, it doesn't really do much if you're a Maokai against a Morgana. I can see why teams are beginning to pick this up. So
Khan falls, but
that was just, you know, overconfidence. He's going 1v3. He's having a little bit of fun, and why not? I mean, this team is just looking so unbeatable at this point. What are you going to do against them? Rocks being totally cut out of the rift right now as a double kill goes over to BDD. That's going to be the 1-0 easy peasy in 34 minutes for Longju.
In the end, Rock Tigers looking good for just a moment until they didn't look good.